gent.
Hey, Dave, man, all right?
What's some sounds going through my head, like, man?
Hey, like, they're sounds that are, like, made of, like, sound.
Except when there isn't any, like... Ooh. Oh, man, this is weird,
hey,
know?
Man, it's like some kind of an echo chamber.
Echo chamber.
I tell you, man, it's, like, freaking me right out, man.
Yeah, me too, man.
Oh, it's Hale of Place!
You're fully dilated.
Oh, really?
Now, get ready to push.
Yeah, yeah, come on, a great big push now. A great big push.
I'm sorry, I think it might be best if you were to leave.
Oh, come on, the magic of childbirth. I've got to get this on video.
But this isn't your wife.
Go on, my son. You can do it. Go on, son, get stuck in.
Come on, come on.
Do it
for
your mum.
Go on, right. Go on.
Yeah, actually, it happened, well, God, many, many years ago. So, how long have you known me now, Norman?
Well, Gareth, I've known you, 24 years for my sins.
What did you say?
24 years.
No, no. The other bit.
For my sins.
Jesus. I really hate that expression.
He's upset.
For your sins, for your sins. I mean, what sins? Have you killed your immediate family and eaten them for Sunday lunch? Is that your sin? I don't think so. Were you the centurion at Calvary who nailed Christ to the cross? Is that your sin? I don't think it is. The only sin you're guilty of is using the moronic phrase, for my sins.
Keep your hair on.
Keep my hair on! Just at the precise second when I was going to take it off, maybe stick it on a lead, maybe take it for a walk around the park. But no, thanks to your invaluable advice, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to keep my hair on.
No need to get your knickers in a twist.
What? What?
Yes!
Knickers in a twist. That's brilliant. Three in a row. Now you're accusing me of being a transvestite who can't even put his little knickers on without getting them in a twist. Is that it? Is that it? Well, let's get this straight for once and for all. My knickers are not in a twist. And the back. Thank you.
There you are, gents. Two ploughman's lunches.
Excuse me. Hey, Vincent, what is this shit on your plate? Some kind of relish?
No, it's pickle.
What about this gonad thing roaming around on my plate?
It's a pickle.
Some bitch. Excuse me, how can that be pickle and that be pickle also?
Well, you see, Jules, this here is a pickle, whereas this is some pickle.
It's too much ketchup.
Now, Vincent, just run that pickle thing past me one more time.
Tarantino's Pub Luncheon.
I've just discovered the everlasting cord.
Well, we should bloody give it back because my pajama bottoms keep falling down.
Hey, hold up. Loads of ladies and gentlemen, geezers, missuses and that. Shut it, button it, zip it, velcro it, silence, a large portion, yes, stop. Introducing to you in the blue jumper. Diamond geezer. Cabby extraordinary Harry. Bandit of 28 handicap. My mate. Father of the bride, Steve!
Frank!
Steve!
Frank!
Steve!
Frank!
Man of few words. Blinding, cracking, handsome. Are a few words which are my favourite. It was a blinding, nay, cracking, nay, handsome wedding. I'm sure you'll all agree.
Here we are. Here we are.
And a geezer here in a dress. Did us proud, right? Not free with standing the fact that he is, in fact, a right cassock lifter. With respect. Tasha, daughter, beautiful, apple of my...
Shut up!
If only her mother could be here to see her little girl on a special day. But she's sleeping it off in the back of the cab, pissed as a fart.
Absent friends.
Absent friends. I would personally like to extend to Kevin here a large portion of welcome.
Gavin here.
He looks like a Kevin to me. Not so much losing a daughter as gaining a ponce. Now, tonight, Kevin will be driving his cab of desire into the Blackwall Tunnel of Ecstasy with my daughter. But that is sweet, because his parents, Charles and Facility, are absolutely bleeding loaded. They can fart money. Charles, right, gentlemen. Facility, wrong side of 50, with respect, but a cracking bit of mutton. With a lovely pair of silicone conkers that would grace any bikini. Money well spent.
Here we are.
I hope you enjoy yourselves tonight. You should do it. Bleeding cost me enough. I have done my bollocks. Toast to the future. Looking rosy. Charles and Facility. Me and my freeloading cabbie mates using your luxury Portuguese villa gratis forever and ever are budge. Danny Gregory!
Quentin Tarantino's Pub Luncheon 2.
Two faggots!
You, Alexander Pushkin, are a drunkard and a scoundrel, sir, and I wouldn't trouble to light my pipe with your verses.
And you, Dmitri Christoph, are a dog, and another dog, and my verses shall live on long after yours have vanished down the sofa of history.
Ha! They say in Petersburg that your verses are used to prop up the short leg on Madame Blavonsky's piano.
Madame Blavonsky is a sow and a woodcock, sir.
I take that as a slight against her honour.
Madame Blavonsky has no honour. For it is said in Petersburg she was once concubine to an entire company of hussars.
Hussars!
It is said in Petersburg that you were once concubine to an entire company of hussars.
Enough of this, sir. I demand satisfaction.
So, an entire company of hussars not enough, eh?
Watch thy tongue, sir, or I shall rip it from your head.
At least my tongue, sir, is in my head. They say in Petersburg that yours is commonly found wedged up the bottom of Prince Orlov.
Prince Orlov is a sow and a woodcock.
You've done that one.
In that case, Prince Orlov is a stoat and a spoonbill, as they do say in Peterborough.
Don't you mean Petersburg?
No, I mean Peterborough. And in Peterborough, they do say he is like a man who boils fish, yet has no cardigan.
No, they say in Peterborough, it's a right bugger to park on a Saturday.
And perna, sir. There is but one way for a gentleman to settle this. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Very well. Pistols at dawn.
Breakfast at Tiffany's.
News of 10.
I say potato.
You say potato. Let's call the whole thing off. Huzzah!
Ah, the White House gambit. Very clever. He's hoping to defend the queen side and then attack with the king's bishop and rook. I'll counter with a Schulmeister defense. So, he's moved his horsey.
Which bit moves diagonal? Was it the row of little nipple heads at the front? Or this one? It looks like a willy.
Last time you cleaned Mr. Flopsy out.
Making bread is a Zen experience. There's a lot of simple things in bread.
I'm in bread and I'm simple.
You take eggs, bacon, 1 pint of milk, cheese and pepper. And then you get arrested by the security man.
Norm. Sam Walkman up, soul.
Not a guitar.
Hey, Jane, hitchhiker.
No, man. Right, yeah, pick him up.
He done gone.
Hey, man.
Yeah, it's nice. What sort of pot is that, man?
Actually, it's pot Paris. It gives you a wonderful buzz, actually.
Yeah, it's nice. It makes the van smell all nice as well. Oh, no, man. Mr. Plod.
Good afternoon, sir.
Sir,
that's the Hasleth ever I heard one.
I just thought you'd like to know. One of your brake lights is defective. Get it fixed ASAP.
ASAP? You can't charge us with ASAP. We ain't done nothing.
Yeah. Hey, this is a hassle-free zone, right?
Yes, why don't you just David Hasselhoff?
I think you dropped this, sir.
Cheers, right?
Jed, man, where the heck have you been?
I spent all morning running around trying to get some milk out of that car.
Jed, that is not a cow, man. That is a bull.
Forget the cereal, I'll just have black coffee, eh?
Really great, man. Can we have that one again?
Yeah, sure.
Hey, can we have Hey, Dave, the sky, man. Like, there's millions of stars.
Ain't no stars there, Jen. Dandruff on your shades, babe.
You know, like the countryside, man. Isn't it a wonderful thing?
The splendor of the English woodland, man. Like, you know, people go too fast to appreciate it.
You couldn't take a handbrake off, could you?
Homogenised milk? Never. Not since I've been a Tory. I did bugger a pound of butter once.
What's going on?
I'm sorry, sir, but you can't go in there.
I live here!
But, sir,
what's happened? Gloria! Gloria! Where's my wife? What's happened to my wife?
I wouldn't go in there if I were you.
Get out of my way! It's Gloria!
I'm sorry, Inspector. I tried to stop him.
Just stay calm, okay?
What's going on?
I can explain everything.
It's great. Well, Tisha made my glasses for me in less than an hour.
Hello. It's me, Johnny. I'm tidying up. Look.
Hello. It's me, Billy. I'm tidying up too. Look.
Can you guess where we are today?
Are we playing leapfrog in a crowded unisex steam room?
No. Are we playing Postman's Knock with a bodybuilder in Wormwood Scrubs?
No. We're at home in our new house.
In our new house with our new friends. Look, who's this? That's right. It's Penelope the pit bull.
Hello, Penelope.
She's very cute.
And she's very happy, because yesterday she had four lovely little puppies.
But today we're going to make sure she only eats normal dog food.
Look, who's this?
That's right. It's Vincent the veal calf.
It's a bit bright in here for you, isn't it, Vincent? Stop it. Look! Who's this? It's Lenny, the louse. But he's no ordinary louse. He's the head louse.
Jenny, I think Lenny wants to talk to me. What's that, Lenny? He says I've got lovely hair, Billy. Get off, Lenny, you big nit.
Okay, playtime's over now. We've got to carry on tidying up.
Yes, I'm going to be downstairs giving it a good polish.
And I'll be upstairs.
Bye-bye.
You've got to be very careful, especially during the winter months, you know? Risk of hypothermia. Just give them plenty of extra blankets and lots of hot cocoa. But on the whole, it's been a lot of fun tour managing the Rolling Stones.
The seedy world of vice has always involved the exploitation of the weak by the strong. But here, on the streets of Llan Bestial, South Wales police are trying to cope with the growth of an area of previously unrecognised vice crime. So, Detective Sergeant, would you say the problem's under control?
I see the situation's getting worse, actually. Well, there's been an alarming increase in the number of sheep prostitutes working the streets at the moment. And it's terrible. I mean, look at that one over there. He's no more than a lamb. Yeah. The butters are coming along now. Yeah, you can always tell the ones that go for the sheep. Yeah, he's back again. He's been here 3 times this week. Look at him. Bare-faced, brazen. Just doesn't care.
The sheep seems to recognise the sound of the tractor engine there.
Well, it's just like a foreplay to a sheep, you see.
The evidence of the problem is quite clear. If we look in this phone box, you'll see what I mean. Some of this stuff is actually pretty sick. Wensleydale, newly arrived in town, call me. Cloven Haven. Bear, bear, black sheep. And it's getting worse. Something seems to be going on over there, Sergeant.
Yeah. I said, right, we're going in. Come on, let's go. Move! Excuse me, sir. Vice Squad would like a word.
Oh, God, no. Really?
I'm a farmer, you see, and I've been transporting Maisie in my car because of the EC regulations.
Can you hold the car, please, sir? Take him away, constable. Come on.
I can explain.
Come on. You just get him.
While in some of the city's top hotels, many sheep ply their trade, urged on by their pimps.
My friend.
A chance meeting in a bar, perhaps, or something a little more shady.
Local Tory MPs are disgusted.
It's absolutely outrageous.
Despite every effort by protesters, the sad abuse of the animals still goes on. Because for sheep lovers, perversity knows no bounds.
Well, the news is not good, I'm afraid. According to these x-rays, you have fractured your skull.
I can't believe it. How can I have been so stupid? Stupid, 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 stupid!